So coming to the classification of class mammalia, actually class mammalia is divided into two major subclasses. So although it is considered as three sometimes, these two together are put under a subclass that is referred to as the theria. So the first subclass would be prototheria and the second subclass would be theria, or you can consider it as individual subclasses as well. So let us look into each of these classes which come under each of these subclasses and infra classes which come under the class mammalia. So like I said, we shall consider the first subclass to be prototheria and the second subclass to be theria, and under the second subclass we have two infra classes. One is called metatheria and eutheria. Prototheria, as you all know, are the egg laying mammals. They have cloaca, they have a single aperture opening for both the excretory and reproductive and the digestive system. It is called the cloaca, and that's why they are also called monotremata, and they are considered to be exhibiting some of the ancestral reptilian characters. So we have duck-billed platypus and the spiny anteater which come under prototheria. Metatheria are also called marsupiala because they have a pouch. So these are the pouched mammals. They are referred to as the marsupials, like the kangaroos and the opossum. Inside the pouch they have the mammary glands. They however have a poorly developed placenta, so the young one takes birth prematurely and then jumps into the pouch, and the rest of the development happens inside the pouch. Now coming to the true placentals, the true placentals belong to an infra class or a subclass that is called eutheria under the subclass that I mentioned, that is theria. It includes order 1, that is insectivora, like moles and shrews. Order 2, that is edentata. Now in edentata, you know about the armadillo, which has long plates on its body, and if it gets disturbed or irritated, it can roll itself. It curls its body, and it also exhibits a phenomenon that is referred to as polyembryony. So from one embryo, many, from one zygote and one embryo, many young ones are produced, and that is called polyembryony. Rodentia are those which have teeth which are modified for gnawing or biting, and they have no canines, and they have a gap present between their incisors and their molars, and this gap in the jaw is referred to as the diastema. This is seen in rats, squirrels and mice. The fourth order is Chiroptera, which you know is the flying mammals, which includes bats. You all know that in bats the forelimb is modified into a structure which has a wing like which is not exactly a wing like you see in the case of birds, but it is a structure which helps in flight with skin stretched in between them. Actually this structure is referred to as the patagium. Singular is patagium, and the two structures together is called the patagia. And then we have order Carnivora. They have very pronounced canines because they are the ones which hunt, and they go after the prey, and they are carnivorous organisms. Now you have all the examples, including the aquatic forms like walruses. Then we have Ungulata. Literally those organisms, those animals in mammals which walk on their toes are called Ungulata. If they have odd number of toes and fingers on their forelimbs and hind limbs, they are referred to as Perissodactyla. So the odd toed ones or Perissodactyla walk on their third digit or the third toe. Prominently in the case of horses, you can see how they walk on their third digit. In rhinoceros, they have three toes, they walk on their three of their toes, and that's why they are called odd-toed organisms. They have a total of 23 vertebrae on their back, and if you see the horn of rhinoceros, it is not actually a bony structure, but it is a mat of agglutinated hair, and it is hollow on the inside. And you all are aware that rhinoceros are poached in order to obtain this highly prized horn. Illegally they are poached in order to extract or harvest this highly prized horn from them by killing them, which is of course illegal. And we also have animals which walk on two toes, that is even toed organisms, like for example you have cattle, you have camel, pig, deer, hippopotamus, giraffe, and these have a very complex stomach. They have a four chambered stomach within which fermentation occurs, and that's why they are called ruminants. So like I said, they have four chambered stomach. The chambers include rumen, reticulum, omasum or psalterium and abomasum. They have a total of 19 vertebrae on their dorsal region, including their thoracic and lumbar. The total number of vertebrae is 19. Then we have order Proboscidea, in whom we see elephants which belong to this order, both the African elephants and the Asiatic elephants. All of you please remember the tusk of the elephant, which has ivory in it, is nothing but the teeth that is enlarged, specifically with teeth, the incisors of the elephant. And elephants are known to have the longest gestation periods. Then we have order 8, that is Sirenia, which are large. Mostly these are aquatic. You will only find them in seas and oceans. They're large herbivorous marine forms. They do not have hind limbs and their forelimbs are modified into paddle-like structures to help them to swim in water. They also don't have the pinna or the external ear. And like I said, they have paddles and they have a horizontal tail paddle. We should not call it as a fin, because fin is a word used only for fishes, so we can call them as a tail paddle. And they also have a thick layer of fat under their skin, which is referred to as the blubber. Example being manatees and dugongs, which belong to this order called Sirenia. Then we have cetacea. Cetacea include all whales and dolphins and porpoises. They also have fat under their skin. They are the largest living animals. Like you know, the whales are the largest living mammals. And they have more number of fingers and toes in their paddle-like structures, that is called hyperphalange. And then you know that they are capable of producing ultrasonic sounds, which help them to navigate in water. And dolphins are quite intelligent and can be trained to do acrobatics. And of course, in these organisms, the testes are not located in the scrotum. It is present within the abdomen. They do not have a structure in their large intestine that is referred to as the cecum. So cecum is absent in these organisms. The last order is the most evolved order to which we belong. It is called Primata. Superior mental powers, called climax group. It includes lemurs, monkeys and anthropoid apes, which are very, very closely related to us. Like you have the gorillas and the orangutans and the chimpanzees. And of course, man belongs to order Primata. We have plantigrade digits. And some of them, you can see that they walk, like if you see a gorilla or an orangutan, it walks on the flat part of its hand and leg, and that is what is referred to as plantigrade. And then you have gibbons and orangutans, which are Asian, while chimpanzees and gorillas are African. And you know that we have flattened nails. The nails are nothing but the modified claws, and we have very large cerebrum, and that is what is attributed to our intelligence, and more number of folds on our cerebrum, which is highly convoluted. So totally 10 orders of class Mammalia that you all should know about.